Guys, welcome to my channel. Today we will be discussing about horsepower or brake horsepower. Both these terms remain same, and this horsepower is nothing. It's just a unit of measurement of power. And now we will see how do we calculate this horsepower. So in order to calculate the same, we have got a formula, and this horsepower, which will be represented as HP, can be calculated by using the formula, as you can see over this file, I mean in this Word file, which is 2 into pi into rpm into torque upon 60, and the value after calculating you will be arriving at will be in terms of watts, and this 2 pi rpm by 60 is nothing, it's just angular velocity, and this torque. So how do you calculate this power? Power will be calculated by using the formula torque into omega. So that means torque into angular velocity, and torque is a force that tends to cause rotations. That means it's a twisting force which you will apply to a rotating body, so that it may deliver a twisting force, which in turn will deliver an output, which you can say it as power. So here we are talking about horsepower, which is the measurement of power. Okay. So, and this torque depends upon angular velocity, means the force which you are applying to a rotating body in order to produce a twisting force, so that it may deliver a particular output. Okay, and this power depends both on torque and angular velocity. So power is associated with this both torque and velocity, and your RPM, it will be defined in terms of revolution per minute. That means per minute how much revolutions or rotations it may be generated. That is what is defined as RPM, revolution per minute. So you can calculate this horsepower by using this formula, that is 2 into pi into RPM into torque by 60. And if you have got a values, suppose if you have an engine having a particular RPM and with a specific torque. So if you substitute both RPM and torque value in this formula, you will be able to obtain a horsepower in terms of watt. And this one horsepower is also defined as 746 watts. I mean, this one horsepower is equal to 746 watts. So where this horsepower will be applied? This horsepower will be you will find it applicable in terms of engine specification. Suppose if you refer an engine specification, there you will come to know that in the technical specification they might have specified this both RPM torque. Okay, so suppose if you consider cars and bikes, that will be having less torque and high RPM, so that your engine and delivery power rate will be high. So normally this cars and bike will be having less torque and more RPM, and this RPM is kept high in order to deliver high power output. But in case of heavy vehicles like trucks and tractors, you will be having high torque and less RPM, but your delivery output will be very less. So likewise, if you compare by varying RPM and torque, you will be able to manipulate horsepower. So in case of engines, I mean like heavy engines like for tractors and trucks, you need to have high load pickup. So in order for that, you need to maintain high torque and less torque, so that your pickup can be achieved, load pickup rate can be achieved. But in that case, your power rating will be very slow. But if you check up with this cars and bikes, you are this thing, you will be having, you can retain less torque and high RPM, so that your delivery output will be high. So guys, see, by varying RPM and torque, you can retain the horsepower as per your requirement. So this is how you evaluate horsepower in case of engine performance. Okay, so normally this horsepower is applicable for specifying engine performance. Okay, so friends, that's all for today. Hope you might have enjoyed this video session, and if you find it useful, I would request you to like, share and subscribe my channel. And again, I'll be coming up with more updated videos. Please do keep on watching my channel. and thanks for watching.